5G is the next evolution of wireless architecture. What it really means is the pervasiveness and connectivity that we see on our smartphones and our iPads is going to get extended out into everything. Today's wireless infrastructure generally looks like a tower in a city, a couple hundred people connected to that tower at any given point in time to do the things that they're doing on their smartphones. And so the US companies that we spend a lot of time with are all trying to figure out how do we take it from the lab and put it into practice in the cities and towns that we all live in. What 5G is going to do is take that one tower, which has probably hundreds of people using it at exactly the same time, and turn that into one small node, you know, perhaps the size of anything from a small pizza box to a fire hydrant or a lamppost. And instead of having hundreds of people riding that same node, it's going to be 40 or 50 people riding that same node. So it's going to allow more people to do more of what they want to do at any given moment in time, which as a result creates massive infrastructure demand on cities. It's going to require more fiber in cities. It's going to require the wireless carriers and anyone who's putting up 5G technology to have access to more spectrum than what's available today. But it's also a very municipal task. You have to go to each city and say, hey, I want to dig up Park Avenue and put some fiber in the street, and I want to hang some fiber from a lamp pole. So it's a really manual and laborious exercise, but something that in general the communication providers are very bullish about doing over the course of the next 10 years. We also think that eventually over time, the more rural communities will also see a version of this. And so in more rural towns where you don't have big buildings and you don't have mountains and things of that nature, it's actually easier to build a wireless network in that town than it is in New York City. And so eventually, after the technology gets honed, we expect massive infrastructure spend to happen in more rural communities across the country. And what we see at the moment is a blurring of the lines between traditional wireless products and businesses and traditional cable broadband products and businesses. Owners of networks will need as much traffic flowing through their network as possible so they can continue to monetize it and earn a return on the capital that's been invested over the course of the last 30 years. And technology companies who have largely lived around the edges of these types of business models will more directly enter these businesses, either via organic development or via M&A. And we could see some interesting combinations of technology companies and telecom and communications companies coming together in a way that 10 years ago none of us would have thought was possible.